How do we know these methods are accurate? We're always using them to date things of unknown age, aren't we? So how do we know if we're right or wrong? The only way to tell is to date something of known age and see how well we stack up against that. That has been done several times. For instance, remember when Mount St. Helens erupted? They actually now have a volcanic dome built up within the crater of Mount St. Helens. They decided to date that thing. And instead of finding out that that thing was 20 years old, they found dates of 340,000 years to 2.8 million years. Now, something's wrong, isn't there? Recent volcanic lava flows in the state of Hawaii were dated not as recent, but as 3 million to 1 billion years old. And that's a major problem. And some people say, could the bad dates just reflect old material coming from the mantle? Well, that sounds like a good explanation, except for the fact that the dating clock is set at zero only when the lava solidifies. Before that time, the liquid lava is as fluid as water. The elements in it are in constant motion, so mixed up, we'll never be able to determine the age. If these dates measure the age of the mantle, like some suggest, we could not use the method to date any of the layers. But then, think about this. If each reflects the mantle age, how come all the layers don't yield the very same age? That's a problem. I was standing on the rim of the Grand Canyon one time, and the geologist ranger was saying, this is an old canyon. Why, it took billions of years to lay down these layers. Everybody's wondering how he knew that, because eyewitness reports is what you need, right? And he didn't look that old to be able to give an eyewitness report. So somebody asked the question, how do you know how old the layers are in the Grand Canyon? He said, they have all been dated by radioactive decay dating methods, and these methods are extremely accurate. Well, I couldn't handle that as a geologist, and I said, sir, are you aware that most of the layers in the Grand Canyon cannot be dated because they contain the wrong kind of rock? He thought about that for a minute and said, oh yeah, I guess you're right. I forgot about that. And then I said, are you also aware that where you can date the rocks in the Grand Canyon, you're coming up with horrible results? He said, what do you mean? I said, well, you're familiar with Vulcan's Throne, aren't you? The lava actually flowed down into the canyon at one time. Now, if I were to date Vulcan's Throne, I should get a very recent age compared to, say, the rock layers underneath the entire canyon. He said, oh yeah, that's exactly the way it is. I said, oh no, it isn't. And in fact, every time they've dated the recent volcanic lava flow by what he considered the most accurate of all the dating methods, they've ended up with dates at least as old and sometimes up to twice as old as the rock layers underneath the entire canyon. He said, no way! Impossible! Your data's got to be false. I said, well, I'll tell you what. Here's a place to look and here's some material. Why don't you go check this out yourself? And then I told him, I'll be back. And the next year I was back. I saw the very same ranger, the very same spot in the canyon, giving the very same ranger talk. So I asked him the same questions. He said, oh, you again. Then he said, I found out you're 100% right. Well, if I'm 100% right, why is he giving 100% the same ranger talk? He said, well, there's a good answer to the problem you brought up. What's that? He said, well, it's been shown that these methods are not accurate on recent events. How do you know that? And just like that, he said, well, every time they've dated something recent with one of these methods, they've gotten horrible results. I said, think about it. If they give you horrible results on rocks of known age, how do you rely on the same methods to give you good results on rocks of unknown age? He had no answer for that one at all. Somebody might say, but don't the different dating methods give the same results? Therefore, we can rely on them? Well, even if they did give the same results, if they rely on the same faulty assumptions, they would likely give the same bad results. But as you can see here, they don't always give us the same results. You can look on the very same layer there, and within the very same layer, the very same method on the same layer, you're ending up with date discrepancies of close to 400 million years. So, I don't think that argument's going to apply at all.